A traditional service to lay a loved one to rest, but now visibly different. Funerals are still allowed to take place in lockdown, but there are no hugs, no handshakes, and no wake afterwards. 92-year-old Adam Hawkes was a beloved father of four and granddad of 15. Described as a proud gentleman, his family are thankful that his death was not due to coronavirus.
I think we did the best under the circumstances, but there would have been a lot more people here if we could have had them. My father didn't have the illness, so we were very fortunate, but nonetheless, the masks and the gloves are a bit of a restriction, but necessary.
Losing a loved one in lockdown has made an already painful situation worse for many families. Government guidance says the number of people attending a service should be kept to a minimum, usually limited to close family members or those within the deceased's household. And social distancing means fighting that basic human instinct to touch and comfort one another.
It's grief upon grief, because a family is in grief because they've lost someone they love. And then they're in grief because they can't give them the celebration of life that they want to give them. And then they're in grief because they can't have the friends and family and loved ones there with them that they need to have, you know, because when you're bereaved, you want people to hold you. You want people to give you their expressions of sympathy and love. And if they're not there, that's really, really difficult.
In the absence of mass gatherings, many families are unlocking the power of technology.
Thankfully, we were able to stream the services over the internet. Originally, the webcasting was put in primarily for family members who might be abroad in Canada or Australia, some America, wherever. But we're finding now that this is a real bonus for families that they're able to connect. We're now seeing up to 70% of attended family services opting for the webcasting service, which we provide for free.
Although we appear to be reaching the peak of the outbreak, families are still being urged not to delay funerals in the hope that the current restrictions will be lifted.
I think it's really important for people to still have funerals, because we don't really want to get to the situation where funeral directors' mortuaries and hospital mortuaries have people that are waiting for funerals for long periods of time. I think undoubtedly things are a little busier than we would perhaps expect at this time of year, and really probably the reason is coronavirus, sadly.
The pandemic is impacting on all religious traditions and is throwing up particular challenges for the Muslim community. The closure of mosques across the country, like this one in Edinburgh, means a swift burial, which is so crucial in Islam, can be difficult.
It's imperative that we do our burials ASAP, just as the same as in Judaism. However, that has been delayed due to pathologists, registrars, and so on, even the gravediggers, for example. So things have really, really been slowed up. And also considering the amount of burials now as well, where, you know, that has obviously multiplied as well.
As the death toll from COVID-19 climbs, it was revealed yesterday that a third of all deaths in Scotland linked to the virus have been in care homes. Reverend Muriel Pearson works closely with a number of care homes in Glasgow and has conducted many funerals for residents who are suspected to have died from the disease.
For one of the families that I'm thinking of, there's quite a lot of anger because the death certificate doesn't say COVID-19, and yet that's clearly what the person died of. They were elderly, they had dementia, but they were fit otherwise. And then over a weekend, they developed respiratory problems. But people may also need to access counselling and professional listening, because this is tough and it will awaken in all of us a feeling of being out of control or in despair that we're not used to.
The lockdown has undoubtedly changed all of our lives, and in death, it is no different. But grieving families are trying to make the best of it, with many postponing memorial services until a sense of normality can return.
We're going to meet in a few months' time, hopefully when the restrictions are all lifted, and have a bit of a get-together. And we're looking forward to that.